It's your boy. How y'all doing? Welcome to my neck of the woods. Eric Taylor, T2UC Victory Astrology, continuing my Juno series. Moving fast. This is Juno in Virgo. Virgo the Virgin, the lyrical surgeon. Yeah. So we're going to talk about Juno, talk about Virgo, and talk about you, because this is your placement. Or maybe someone that you're in a relationship with. So what is Juno? Juno in Greek mythology is the asteroid for long-term relationships, marriage, and, you know, deep, intimate commitment, okay? So Juno was, you know, Jupiter's wife. They may or may not have been siblings, but it's got a little Libra, Scorpio feel to it, but it's definitely about, you know, long-term relationships, commitment, and marriage, okay? And it's one of the indicators in the natal birth chart that I use for a synastry compatibility chart, or a mini relationship chart. You look at the Juno, the Venus, the Jupiter, the seventh house, all that good stuff. No. Stop thinking about the Mars. I know you're naughty. That's just for the sex and the boyfriends. Okay? Talk about love, commitment, relationships, marriage. So that's Juno. So what is Virgo? I'm a Virgo. But when you have Juno and Virgo, this means that you could potentially be in a relationship or marriage with a Virgo sun, moon, or rising sign. Okay, and remember, Juno's kind of like that double-sided mirror. So it's like the energy you may find in a partner, but it's also the energy that you're kind of putting out and desiring as well, right? So the reason why you hit me up, taylor2coaching@gmail.com, because this Juno and Virgo, what house is it in? Is it in the first, the fifth, the 8th, the 10th, the 11th, it does matter, because it tells the theme and the story of how you could potentially meet this partner, all right? So Juno and Virgo, what's that like? Virgo, right? The mutable earth sign, sixth sign in astrology, second earth sign. It's ruled by the planet Mercury, okay? Virgo the Virgin is about the wheat and the medicine, rules the lower intestines and the tummy and the belly, right? Virgo is logical, analytical, critical, right? This is a feminine energy. They are very picky, precise. Sometimes a perfectionist. They can be self-critical, critical of others, but they're also about service. Virgos aim to please. They want to fix things, fix people. They want to be helpful. The best personal assistant you could ever have, right? So in this situation, for a relationship or marriage, you may attract someone that really wants to take the time to get to know you. They want to know every nook and cranny, every detail. What's your favorite color? What's your favorite outfit? Favorite food? Favorite dessert? Favorite movie? What's your favorite book? Right? Your favorite sport? Favorite athlete? All that good stuff. Your favorite dress? Flower? So whether you're male or woman, these people are about health and service and hygiene. So don't be messy, right? But also understand they like cleanliness and people that are healthy. Juno and Virgo, they want a partner that works hard. That's what, you know, Virgo energy is about. Hard work, fixing things, analyze. These people might help you balance your checkbook, or they may help you invest, right? How to save your money properly. A good exercise plan, a new, you know, way of eating. You know, I hate to say the word diet, it's live it. Right? But a new way of eating food, or, you know, are you drinking enough water? Are you getting your vitamins and minerals, enough vitamin D in the sun, right? These people, they want that teamwork, okay? So this is a great relationship. And understand, Juno and Virgo, you have this, you don't want to play around. You want the marriage. You want the long-term commitment. You know, I know younger generation, millennials, you know, Gen Z, might not be into marriage as much, but definitely a long-term committed relationship. This is, you know, pretty serious here. And they're about, you know, working at it, trying to fix things. And they want to know how to please you, because they're all about service. If you tell them, they'll get it done. It's the Virgo way, okay? And funny, you know, very witty, intelligent people. You know, some of the downsides and negatives, you know, I gotta be, you know, me, I'm gonna keep it real with you, right? Juno and Virgo could be a Debbie Downer, self-critical. They could worry about you a lot, a worry wart. They can be really picky, right? Hard to please sometimes. But it's funny because they're kind of yin-yang with that. They're like, they're hard to please, but then they're easy to please. You could also see where they could, you know, have somewhat of that perfectionist thing. And they can be, because they're so smart, you know, they, Juno and Virgo, you're not going to want a partner, whether it's you or your partner, and they're Junos and Aries or Taurus or whatever else. They're going to want a partner that's pretty presentable, but intelligent. Okay? Definitely intelligent. Juno and Virgo can be sometimes a little quiet, shy, reserved. But overall, when, you know, once they really, like, you know, feel that level of commitment and trust, you're going to have fun. And they're going to aim to please. That service can be massage, running the bath, fixing things, buying things for you, just being thoughtful, considerate, the perfect gift, you know? If you ask them, like, oh, do I look good in this shirt? Or do you like this tie on me? Or how do I look in this dress? Or, you know, stuff like that. They're not going to just be, like, blunt, like Juno and Sag, and be like, oh, not good. They'll say, okay, well, that looks nice, but maybe you should put on the red shirt. Or maybe you should wear the blue tie with that, you know, blazer, honey. You know what I mean? They're going to give you the helpful tip and hint to make it mo better. Right? Virgo wants it mo better. So definitely a pleasure war. They aim to please. And, you know, hey, we all hope that everything in these situations, the relationships, your career, whatever, it's on the higher vibration. Because the low vibration, they can freaking be super critical of you, rip you apart. You're like, oh my gosh, just stop. You're Debbie Downer. You know, you're getting annoying. You're being too critical. So you got this Juno and Virgo, make sure that you be nice. Don't be the worrywart. Don't be super anxious. Don't think negative about outcomes, situations, places you're gonna go, the date. Be optimistic. You can learn that from Juno and Sag, okay? But they're very practical and they can make your life way more efficient and be extremely helpful and a great support, a cheerleader, you know what I mean? And I don't mean it in a negative way. Like, I mean, like, really someone that's got your back, that's boosting and lifting you up. Like, yo, we got this. We're taking over the world. Okay? Power couple. Yeah, Juno and Virgo can do all that. So, you know, thanks for coming over here. Please comment, like, share it, you know. Put it up on your Facebook, your Twitter, you know. Let folks know about your boy. I really appreciate it. And check me out, right? Tailored to you coaching at Facebook and at the Patreon. Got two tiers over there, $5, $10 a month. We got some exclusive content that's not here on YouTube. Tailored to astrology on the TikTok and the Instagram. Okay, and then the Twitter, tweet at me, follow me, subscribe, check out all the social media. Tailored to C and at Big 3 Astrology. And don't worry, soon I'll be making changes. It's type of, try to really streamline it so it's all cohesive for you. All right, I'll be fixing up the website soon too. So, but you want to book anything, email me directly at tailoredtocoaching@gmail.com. And happy birthday, Aquarius. It's Aquarius season. So take advantage of my Aquarius birth chart sale, right? A full 12 house written report with videos of your placements is normally $175. It's only going to be $130. If you want the same thing plus the 40 to 50 minute mini movie of your life, live. That's normally $250, only $210. So Aquarius sun sign folks, it's your time. Holla at your boy. Email me. Like, yo, Eric, I'm an Aquarius. I'm ready. All right, Juno and Virgo, right? Enough of that Aquarius stuff. It's about you, Juno and Virgo. And maybe you've fallen in love with Aquarius. You've connected mentally. Some health, some science, some technology. They both like that, you know? So, all right, Juno and Virgo. Enjoy the love and be nice. All right, Eric Taylor, T2UC Big 3 Astrology. Deuces. Later.